live on Facebook.
What up, Facebook?
Hello, everybody.
Yay.
Like disappearing hands with my background.
Those are your post-Halloween magic hands.
I know. Skills. Good morning, Facebook world. It's raining. It's officially fall. We had all that beautiful weather. It was so nice yesterday. It was even really warm. It's great. Ryan got in his last baseball game of the season.
Oh.
I know. It's good stuff. We're going to Palm Springs next week. It's been like 95 degrees for a month. It's going to be 70 next week.
No way. Right.
Here we go.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the 425 Show, your place to be for all things real estate and lifestyle related here on the East Side. I'm your host, Nicole Mangina with Windermere Real Estate. It's Tuesday. It is November 3rd. It is Election Day. Oh, my goodness. I want to thank everybody who showed up to vote in this election, because voting's always a big deal. But I think in this election, it feels like now more than ever, I think it's very, very cool to see how many people are showing up to vote, how it's just the way it's going on social media and everything. I was reading a statistic over the weekend that for a lot of states, the mail-in ballot count leading up to today is close to or at the usual voter turnout for an election. So I think that's just a really cool thing. And it doesn't even matter who people vote for, it does matter. Meaning, I'm not even concerned about whether you voted for the same candidate as I did. I just think the fact that we're all showing up to make our voices heard is really special, because I think it's something we take for granted quite often. And the fact that people are really owning that is cool. So I want to congratulate everybody who has and or is voting in the election. It's not too late. Get out there, make your voice heard. I will say, though, one thing that's a little different about this election, we'll see how it all plays out, but going into it, I have noticed it myself and I've seen it with other people as well. There's kind of this underlying like, let's see how this whole thing plays out from a violent standpoint and what may or may not happen in the next couple of days. I'm going to continue to hope for the best and hope that we all continue to love and respect each other the way I think we are meant to. But one thought I'd like to leave everybody with is each and every day, I know for myself, the biggest determiner in my day is how I choose to show up in my day and how I choose to see things. So I think if we all go with that moving forward, hopefully that'll be good for everybody. But anyway, happy voting day. I think it's a pretty cool thing. It's a privilege that we all get, and I think it's great to take advantage of. There you go. My soapbox for the day. Thanks for listening to that. Real estate update. Market continues to be strong. I think I'll probably have a juicier update for you next week because I'll be able to tell you kind of what's happened post-election. But interest rates are still good. Things are still selling. Things were selling over the weekend. They were selling yesterday. So people are in it. We still need places to live, which is a beautiful, beautiful thing. If you have real estate on the brain and want to know more about the local market, I invite you to reach out. You can always find me via email, nicole@nicolemangina.com. There you go. Without further ado, I'm excited for our guest today, Brandelyn Tafoya with Lady 12s. How are you?
Hi, I am doing fabulous, actually.
It's yay!
Rainy out, but that gives me a break from outside work, so I can get inside and get things done.
Yeah, the first couple of rains of the season, I kind of like you said, it's a change and makes me feel all snuggly. I want, wear a sweater and drink hot tea all day, and in a couple months, I'll be over it. But
oh, totally. Yes, totally. When Christmas is over, that's a long month.
Yeah, exactly. So we had a great conversation before the show about, again, just finding the good things that are going on in the world right now. We were talking about Halloween and how it was different in both of our houses, but it's kind of falling in line with the rest of this year in that it sparked some creativity and some new really fun things. So hopefully that'll just be our mantra for the rest of the year. Creativity and new fun ways to look at things.
Yes, I think it is. Moving forward in life, I think we've gained some life skills and gotten a little bit more nimble, not so set in our ways. And that's a good thing.
I think it's as for sure, for sure. So, and I think that applies to business, and you are a business owner. So I think it's only fitting that we're talking about that today.
Yes.
So a little backstory, you own Lady 12s, which is a clothing company. You do Seahawks gear for mainly women, correct?
Yeah, mostly, yeah.
Yeah, mostly women. And we've actually got a football season now, so we can all wear our Seahawk gear, which is kind of fun. And you also did some pivots this year, and you've got masks and all that kind of stuff. You've got a pretty cool story about how you came into doing all of this in the first place. So I'd love to hear from you.
Sure. Yeah. Well, the apparel journey and the fanwear journey started. Well, actually, let me take you back a little bit further than that. My husband played 8 years in the NFL. Mm-hmm. I met him when he moved about a week after he moved to Bellevue to play for the Seahawks. Uh-huh. And we met at Whole Foods at the grocery store.
So you met him while he was playing for the Seahawks?
Yeah. Yeah. I met him.
Better.
Yeah, no, it was, that's just a different life, you know, that whole thing. It was a whirlwind and it's a different lifestyle. And you look back on it later and you're like, wow, that's just such an alternate reality, but it was our reality at the time, you know? So, so yeah, he played another couple of years in the NFL after I met him. And then he was forced to retire with an injury, and him and I are both very entrepreneurial people. We just are always coming up with different ideas, and our hot tub, we call it our office because we sit in our hot tub and we just come up with all of these different new crazy things, and 90% of them fail and the 10% that don't are great.
Yeah, you know? I love it.
The life of an entrepreneur, right? But he actually was promoting a brand called Volume 12 and the Legion of Boom back when the Seahawks went and won their first Super Bowl, the first one that they won. So back in 2013, he was promoting those brands, and we opened a store to sell some merchandise around those brands. And I was just there all the time because I had a little baby and a two-year-old at the time, and just was hanging out at the store just to be around him, and was watching the amounts of women coming in looking for gear, and there's just was nothing, you know. It was just was so hard. And I know going to the games myself, I was always scrambling to put something cute together that was the right colors, and there just wasn't a lot of
boxy and
yeah, a bunch of men's t-shirts with Seahawks logos on them. I mean, it's there's only so many ways you can dress that up. So all of a sudden I just was like, you know what? If these guys can make apparel, I can try and make apparel. And so I got my creative juices going and started to put some t-shirt designs together. And it really just snowballed after that. Within that first year, we were selling wholesale to Albertsons and Bartell Drugs. And it's been crazy ever since. That year, my husband was actually the one who did the effort to break the world record of the noise in the stadium.
Oh, no way. That's awesome. Yeah.
And so we were actually the ones that paid Guinness to come out, the Guinness Book of World Record, to come out and go into the stadium and do all of the testing. We had all the sound engineers and all of that. So it was just like a crazy fan involvement year for us. We just really immersed ourselves in the fan community that year. And it just showed us, you know, where there was need in the market. So it's been really fun.
I think that's awesome.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I didn't know that you guys were behind the whole Guinness Book of Records thing for the noise and stuff.
Yeah, that was an experience. Yeah. So our thing is sparkle. So I've always been I love having sparkle on my clothing. It's just, sparkles are my thing. So pretty much everything we make has some element of sparkle in it, or on it, apparel wise, which is fun.
That's awesome. Well, and I think, you know, you were talking a lot about community too. And that's really what this is all about, right? It's, you know, you're a local business, but to me, that's what sports are. There's so many things, right, that bring people together, sports, watching sports, all of these things. It's just about being part of a community.
It really is. Yeah.
And so that's pretty cool. And so your website, if people, because you do have things in stores, but you can also buy online as well, correct? And your kind of new 2020 collection is all online on your website.
Correct. Yeah. We this year have decided to do everything we make for 2020 is going to be a limited edition, only available on our website. And then a couple of things from this year are going to be available on Amazon. And we're just trying to get everything we can listed on Amazon right now, because that is, it's where everyone's shopping right now.
I know, right? And I know there's kind of a, you know, I don't know if love hate is the right word, but, or the right phrase, but you know, there's pros and cons to having everything on Amazon. But I think you're right, as a business owner, people are already on that website. So if you can get your stuff on there, it probably makes a ton of sense.
Yeah, you can only swim against the current for so long before you realize, okay, it's a lot easier to just go this way.
Absolutely. But so how do people find you, either with your website or if they want to find you on Amazon? How do they find you?
Our website is lady12s.com. So it's lady12s.com. Okay. And then on Amazon, you can search lady12s. It's kind of a maze on Amazon, but we do have a store on Amazon. So if you search that, you can find our Lady 12 store, and then it'll show all of the listings that we have on there.
But, yeah. I love it. Well, and your stuff is super, super cute.
Thank you.
And it is in everything, right? I think the whole embracing women's apparel for all of these different things, everything from professional football to, quite honestly, my son's baseball teams, right? You know, as women, we want to show up, we want to support it. We're all for wearing the gear, but
you want to look cute.
We do.
Why should fashion fly out the window just because sports are involved?
You want something with a little sparkle, a little zest to it. So I think it's great. I think I love all of the things you have on your website.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you.
And you guys have done a pivot as well this year, and you've got some great masks on there as well.
We do. That was an interesting experience, actually. And that really came back to the community aspect of our brand, because when we first decided we were going to make masks and launch them, just the overpouring of people that were like, oh my gosh, thank you for doing this. I'm going to buy them from you because I trust you. You know, just we had such a customer base that already had our products. They knew they could trust our products. A lot of them know us personally. We've been so involved in the community that we've gotten to know a ton of our customers and the fans and all of that. So we launched the masks, and that was a huge hit, because that's a really, I feel like, kind of a personal product, a mask, you know, something you're going to buy to put over your face and, you know, trust to have some element of protection.
Yes, for sure.
Especially when we all first started wearing masks, that was so weird, right?
Oh my gosh, yes.
It was the most foreign, bizarre concept when we first started to do it. And now it's, you know, it's kind of just commonplace now, but, it was really cool to see how, when you build a brand and you build trust with that brand, how important that is. And then when you reach a hard spot, you can take that trust and move everything in a completely different direction and have your customers follow you, which was really cool.
And that does say a lot. Like you said, building a relationship with your clients. And that's, you know, that's the whole reason I do this show, because I am so committed to supporting local people in our community. And sharing that message, because it is, once you've built a relationship with people, you support each other, right? They follow you and you support them. We all need these masks, like you said. I mean, I think, I know even in our house, we were just doing the disposable ones for a while. We're like, this isn't going to last, you know, we'll just get a box of disposable ones.
Sure. Well, yeah.
it's here to stay, at least for the short term. It's, you know, you might as well invest in some masks and, you know, ones that you can wash out and all of that kind of stuff. And
definitely.
I think we've all figured out we're not actually going to suffocate in them, because I don't know about you. It's like, I can't breathe. I can't see. Like, this is just bad.
I know. It's the adjustment phase. It really, we've had to adjust to a lot as human beings this year. We have to give ourselves all a pat on the back. You know, it's been
for sure. Yeah. So, you know, if you can wear some cute Seahawks gear and have a mask that looks pretty cute, then I think that's, you know, you're going to take your wins where you can get them.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Thank you for supplying really cute stuff. Where do you get your inspirations for your designs?
Oh, you know, that's a good question. So I'm a super particular person. I'm totally a perfectionist when it comes to, and so I just figure out things that I like, and then I'm like, oh, let's throw it out there and see if everyone else likes it too, you know? So like, I really love floral designs. So at one point in time, we did a Seahawks colored floral pattern, you know, and made a bunch of stuff with that. And just different, finding different patterns and then just kind of throwing the Seahawks flair to it. And then recently this year, we totally have pivoted and are trying to make stuff for, so our everyday lifestyle, we live on a farm.
Okay.
I'm a 100% farm girl. And so now we've started a new brand that's centric around that. And so that's been really fun to use new colors, because I found myself, my creativity was struggling for a while there when I can only use specific colors.
Yeah.
And so now I have a new outlet, which is good.
We all love blue and green, but every now and then you need something other than that.
Yeah. When that's all you can do, then it, you know, anytime you're put in a box, you want to get out of that box. That's just the way it goes. Right.
But I think that's part of the fun too, though, is when you start bringing in, you know, other things and you still mix in a logo or something like that. To me, that's, well, cause I'm a girl, part of the fun of going to the events is I'm like, oh, check out that cute shirt. Or where did they get that? Right. When there's some variation and looks like something unique and individual about it. So I think that's great. And you guys have two young kids that you are schooling as well and doing a lot with. Are they involved in the business at all? Do you get them involved with it?
They are involved in everything.
Are they?
They're 100% part of our lives. We actually started homeschooling about a year and a half before the pandemic hit. Just because it was what was right for our family. Now, the funniest part was everyone we knew looked at us like we were absolutely nuts, bonkers. These guys have lost their minds, right? Fast forward a year and a half later, a lot of people want to know a lot of information what we're doing. No, but in all seriousness, it's been absolutely so fun to support other moms and other families that just need help right now. And some have made the transition also just because it was easier for their lives. And that's been really fun. But our kids are part of every single thing we do. A lot of their education, we just involve them in stuff. You know, we're constantly teaching them stuff and we love spending time with them. And they put stickers on products and help us pack packages and, you know, anything that we can pull them into. So they're part of the process and coming up with ideas.
Do they? I think that's great.
It's so fun. Yeah.
I think it's great for them and it makes it fun for you guys, I'm sure. And what a cool experience they're getting. And I know one of our boys, especially when he was younger, he used to love, you know, whenever I put together like a gift or something for someone, he used to always love to tie the bows. Right. And so that was his thing. And it's funny. I remember I was in a store one time and they were doing a bunch of packaging and the gal was tying the bows and Ryan, our son, was like, he wanted to do it. So I told the gal, I was like, hey, can you put it all together and he'll tie the bows. And of course he had like the 8-year-old version of bow tying at the time. And I could tell the gal was like freaking out because this was not going to be to her standards. I'm like, look, I'm thrilled with this bow. I think it's amazing. Right. And but it was all about the experience. And then whenever I gave one of those gifts, I got to tell him and Ryan tied your bow and that just made it special. Right.
I love
that. The person receiving the gift thought it was great. And So I think anytime you can involve your kids in what you're doing, whether it's something big or even something as little as, you know, just like you said, putting a sticker on something or tying a bow, it's a special moment. And it, really? I think it has an impact on them in the future as well.
Definitely. Huge impact. Yes.
So
empowerment is a big thing. You know, any way you can empower a child is going to help them in their growing process.
For sure. So will you have a 2021 collection for Lady 12s? You've got the 2020 collection is online right now. They can go to your website, just straight to your website or to Amazon.
Yeah.
And then if you go to their website.
Yeah. If you follow our social media, we're still launching the 2020 collection.
Got it.
Okay. When we do it, we kind of do it throughout the season. We'll kind of launch like a new product each week. Typically we have a fashion show every year. And so that's our big launch for everything. Not doing that this year. So our launch process looks a little different. So we're just kind of doing everything online each week.
Yeah.
But there's a few more items that are still left to launch for this year. But yeah, I mean, we're just doing the best we can with it. We didn't know if we were going to have a season until right before the season started. And apparel is one of those things where it's a large investment and you can't just make stuff overnight. You know, it's a planning process. And so we had to find products that we could make quickly, still have my Brandelyn touch to it, which is hard in a quick turn scenario. We ended up, most of our stuff was manufactured for the last 6 years. You know, it's like a 6 month planning process, manufactured overseas. I can pick everything down to the size of the sequin or, you know, the zippers and all of that. And so we couldn't do that this year. So it's been, you know, just trying to find ways to make everything work. But I feel like we've got some cute stuff. I'm happy with it. I think the customers are going to like it too. It's all still really good quality. It's just as we had to do it a little quicker.
Yeah. That's okay, right?
Yeah.
There'll be something you take out of this year that you'll be able to use next year and, you know, adjustments to your video or business and all that kind of stuff.
I think that our structure of Lady 12 right now, the way that we are doing things is probably how it's going to run moving forward, to be honest. The online and Amazon thing, that might be how we move forward, which is fine. That's great. We've learned a ton. So
I think that's great. If you're just tuning in today, we've got Brandelyn Tafoya on the show with us. She is the owner of Lady 12s. You can find them lady12s.com. Lady is spelled out 12s.com. We'll also have the links on our website after the show. Super, super cute and individual and awesome Seahawks gear that is actually fit for women. So you can still look cute when you're supporting your team. A little sparkle to it, all kinds of good stuff. And the Seahawks are having a good season. Like, it's a good season. Where are you?
They're helping us out.
Yeah.
One. They're doing great.
Yeah.
I know.
Amazing. So, and you know, we're all still in our work from home gear. So why not work from home in some Seahawks gear?
Right. Everything we make is very comfortable. I will definitely guarantee you that.
So consider it your good luck thing. Like, you know, we're all superstitious, right? You got to buy some Lady 12s gear, wear for all the games. They'll keep winning. It's totally how this whole thing is going to work. They're going to the Super Bowl all because we're all wearing Lady 12s gear. I think that's what it's all about.
That's exactly how it's going to go.
It could happen. I can see it.
That's wonderful.
So again, you've got all your stuff. Do you have things in stores right now? Some things.
There are stores. So we have been up till this year selling to Albertsons and Safeway and their team shops. Whenever you go into a Safeway and you see the Seahawks section, we had a full rack in there. So there's stuff from last year's season still in the stores.
Got it.
And then Bartell Drug as well.
Okay.
But this year, COVID hit right when stores were placing all their orders.
And
I mean, at that point in time, it didn't look like we were having football. And so nobody could order. I mean, it wouldn't have been smart for anybody at that point in time. So
yeah.
We just kind of rode with it, you know?
Yeah. Now it's all online, which I think, you know, that's been one of my skills I have learned this year is my whole online shopping ability. And I say it's a learned skill because I have done my fair share of buying things online and it shows up. I'm like, huh, not at all what I thought I just bought.
Yeah. Yeah. And boxes show up at the gate and we're like, okay, there's a pile of boxes out there. And I don't even remember what I ordered. Yeah. It's almost like Christmas when we go out there.
Totally.
It was so funny last week. I hadn't been to Target in like months, right? Oh, no. Joe does all of our grocery shopping and I literally stay on the farm. I don't go anywhere. And all of a sudden I just had this craving for like walking around Target, holding a latte, just like walking up and down the aisles and just really looking at stuff, you know, like that actually sounds like self-care to go to Target right now and just retail therapy. Just look at stuff, buy stuff.
That's awesome. How was it? Was it all it was cracked up to be or no?
It was great for like the first three quarters. And then I looked at my cart and I'm like, oh, this was such a horrible idea. and then the buyer's remorse sets in. No, it just was funny. It was just such a sign of like where we are right now. Everything's just so weird.
Sure. It's a different experience for sure.
Yes.
That is awesome. Well, I love that you're keeping the dream alive. You still got your business going. You're still making cute gear for all of us. You're making awesome masks. I feel like all of us are due for a refresh of masks as well, right?
Hey, yeah.
All the ones we bought initially are all getting a little worn, even with washing. So we're all ready for, let's get a fresh round of things. They'll be our holiday season masks.
Totally. Yeah. And ours that we have right now, we actually have dialed the mask thing in. So the ones that we're selling right now, machine washable, they've got an antimicrobial layer that cuts down odor and all of that. They go over the ears, easy on and off. They're actually very breathable. I kind of love our masks right now. Actually, it makes the whole thing a lot easier. So
that's awesome.
Yeah.
I think the antimicrobial thing is key too, because they can get a little funky.
Yes.
Assuming you wear them more than once between washings, which I do.
Right. Yes.
So, and they, you know, it's all about the cut of the mask too, right? It's what the other thing we've learned of like some really work, others like you can't help but breathe them in. The cut of yours is key. So you got some good masks for people to check out for sure.
No, we do. We actually have one of the Nike factories making them right now. So they're
sweet.
They're good masks.
Awesome. Good stuff. Right on. Well, see, small businesses, local businesses, you can support your favorite football team, assuming it's the Seahawks. I guess I should have said local football team, which for most people, I think is the same. And you can support a local business, whether you're buying a mask or Seahawk gear that makes you look cute and ready for the weekend and the game. I don't even know. Who are they playing this weekend? Do you know? I don't know. That was a trick question for both of us. Doesn't matter.
I sit down on the couch and watch the game with Joe. He like does all of the stat tracking and
the free stuff. Like, yeah. I don't really know either.
The Buffalo Bills, looking at
this. Oh, there you go. Buffalo Bills.
It's in a Buffalo, so.
Oh, ooh. Well, there you go.
Traveling day.
Yeah. That'll be one to watch from home, no matter what. Awesome. Thank you for joining us today, Brandelyn. I appreciate you on the show.
Oh, no, thank you so much. It was a pleasure.
Absolutely. We'll have links to everything on our website after the show, NicoleMangina.com/podcast. Have an awesome Tuesday. Get out and vote if you haven't already, and we'll see you next week. Bye.
Cool, ladies. All clear.